Dear students, sir, how are you? Today we are going to discuss some MCQ which are asked in our NEET exam. Then after we will discuss some other question. So which type of question is asked in our exam? So for better understanding, we are starting with the ask exam, ask the questions in NEET exam. So in last year 2019, first question for the cell reaction, for the cell reaction to Fe+3 aqueous plus 2I minus gives up 2 Fe+2 plus I2. E degree cell is plus 0.24 volt at 298 Kelvin temperature. The standard gives the free energy change of this cell is given Faraday constant 96500 coulomb per mole, means charge of 1 mole electron. We have to define value of delta G. Yes. First of all, we know delta RG formula is equal to minus NF EN cell. EN cell is given, you can see. Faraday constant is given. We have to derive N from reaction. Fe+3 × +2. 1 Fe+3 convert into Fe+2 gains 1 electron. So 2 Fe+3 gains 2 electron. So 2 electron is gained. 1I minus loses 1 electron. So 2I minus loses 2. So here N equal to 2. F is the 96500. And E degree cell is given 0.24 volt. So coulomb into volt. So answer 4346320 joule per mole. When we divide by 1000, so kilo joule per mole is our answer. In 2019, this one asked. Now next, this one also in 2019. Question: for a cell involving 1 electron, involving 1 electron, E degree cell is 0.59 volt at 298 Kelvin. The equilibrium constant for the cell reaction is we have to derive equilibrium constant and value of 2.303 RT upon F is 0.059 at temperature 298 Kelvin is also given. We have to derive equilibrium constant. So E cell, answer, E degree cell 0.059 upon 1. Why? Only one electron is involving in reaction. One is lost, one is gained. Log K, equilibrium. Whenever cell is in equilibrium, so E cell will be 0. This begin 0. E degree cell is given 0.59, 0.059 log K. So 0.59 equal to, sorry, this one comes here from right hand side to left hand side, 59 log K, 0.59. So log 10K, 0.59 upon 0.059. So log 10K will be 10. Yes. Ultimately, if another side digit is involved, whole digit, fraction now. So directly we can text as the rest of opposite value. But in answer is given like this. Both are same. 1 into 10 raised to 10 is our answer. Understood? Now, 2017 and 2003, two times asked a question. 2017 and 2003, two times asked same question. In the electrochemical cell, Zn oblique ZnSO4, 0.01 molarity salt bridge. Copper sulfate, 1 molarity oblique C. The EMF of this cell is suppose E1. When the concentration of ZnSO4 is changed to 1 molarity and that of copper sulfate changed to 0.1 molarity, 0.01 molarity. The EMF changes to E2. The potential is now E2 after changing the concentration. From the following relation, which one is a truth? RT upon F value, we know 0.059. Option is E1 is less than E2, B, E1 is greater than E2, C, E2 equal to 0, but E1 not 0, and D, E1 equal to E2. Just tell me, this is our Daniell cell. So actually what happens here, put down the equation, Nernst equation, E star means E1 equal to E degree 1, 0.059 upon 2. Zn gives Zn plus 2, Cu plus 2 gives Cu. So n is equal to 2 log. Concentration of the anode here and concentration of the cathode. So E degree 1 minus 0.0296 log 0.01 upon 1 means log 10 raised to minus 2. 0.01 10 raised to minus 2. So E1 degree here 0.059 by 2. 2 comes here as a minus 2 and log 10. 2 took a minus minus plus. So E1 degree plus 0.059 log 10 1. This is E1. Now E2 is equal to E2 degree for second condition. 1 for first condition, 2 for second. Minus 0.059 upon 2. Same. Here concentration is changed. Zn is 1. Now it is a 1. So upward 1. Then so copper sulfate is not 1. Now 0.01. So E2 degree. 0.059 upon 2 log. Log 1 minus log 10 raised to minus 2. Value of log 1 0. Minus come here plus 2 and 1. So E2 degree 0.059 by 2 into cut. So E2 degree minus 0.059. So E2 is less, E1 is more. 0.059 is adding here in E1. Here minus. So E1 is greater than E2. So answer is B. Understood? This is the method to solve your question. Now 2016. This question asked two times in 2017 and 2003. Now we are in another question of 2016. In 2016, two times NEET exam conducted two times in 2016, phase 1, phase 2. So there are four questions of 2016. The molar conductivity of a 0.5 mol per decimeter cube solution of AgNO3 with electrolytic conductivity of 5.76 into 10 raised to minus 3 Siemens per centimeter at 298 Kelvin temperature is a molar conductivity of 0.5 is given. We have to define here molar conductivity. K is given, Siemens per centimeter. Molar conductivity is equal to 1000 into K upon C. Here 1000, K is a specific conductivity, electrolytic, 5.76 5.76 10 raised to minus 3. And mole per decimeter cube means mole per liter. Decimeter cube means liter. So whenever molarity given, so 1000 comes here. So 0.5. So 1000 and 10 raised to minus 3 cut. 5.76 into 10 divided by 5. So, sorry, 11.52. Yes, answer is 11.52. Siemens into centimeter square into mole inverse is our answer. Now, question number, once again in 2016. During the electrolysis of molten sodium chloride, the time required to produce 0.1 mole of chlorine gas using a current of 3 ampere is answer 55 minute, B 110 minute, C 220 minute, and D 330 minute. Molten means not aqueous. Molten NaCl we have to take here. Electrolysis of molten NaCl means Na plus liquid and Cl minus liquid. We are passing current throughout it. So chlorine moves toward anode. So we have 2Cl minus experiences oxidation gives Cl2 plus 2 electron. For getting 1 mole chlorine, needed charge is 2 into 96500 coulomb. 2 mole electron means 2 farad. 2 farad means 2 into 96500 coulomb. For 1 mole chlorine, needed coulombs 2 into 96500. For 0.1 mole, how much? For 0.1 mole chlorine, how much? 0.1 into 2, 96500 upon 1. Yes, tell me. Multiplication of it. So, coulomb will be 0.1 into 2 into 96500 19300 19300 coulomb is needed. Ready? Now how much time required? So Q is equal to I into T. Q is derived. I in ampere given. So here answer comes in second. 19300 divided by 3. 6433. in second, but given answering minute, so divide by 60. So 107.22 minute comes. So exact answer is not given in this question, so near about. Yes, so sometimes we have to take a near about answer. So 110 minute is our answer. Understood? Now next, also asked in two times, 2016 and 2011. So if the e-degree cell, for a given reaction has a negative value, which of the following gives the correct relationship for the values of delta G degree and equilibrium constant? E degree cell having negative value less than 0. Answer: delta G degree greater than 0, equilibrium less than 1, delta G degree greater than 0, K equilibrium greater than 1, C delta G degree less than 0, equilibrium constant more than 1, and D delta G degree less than 0, equilibrium constant less than 1. So what happens here? Tell. I am giving you formula. Delta G degree is equal to minus NF E degree cell. E degree cell is minus. So minus minus plus. Delta G will be plus. So delta G plus means greater than 0. This is trick to solve. And wherever delta G is positive, so K will be negative. Another, delta G is equal to minus 2.303 RT log K. Here value of delta G is positive. So 2.303 RT log K. So K should be less than 1. If K 1 hoy, so 0 thai delta G. Delta G positive kya tha? Whenever value of K is less than 1, suppose 1 half. So minus 2.303 log 1 minus log 2. Here 0, 0.3010, so minus minus positive. So K is less than 1. Proven, K less than 1 and delta G greater than 0. So answer is A. Understood? Now in 2016, 2016. Rain. This question was 2 times, 2016 and 2011. Now in 2016, once again, the number of electrons delivered at the cathode during electrolysis by a current of 1 ampere in 60 seconds is in charge on electron is 1.60 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulomb. Number of electrons delivered at the cathode during electrolysis by a current of 1 ampere. We know Q is equal to I into T. And also, Q is equal to N into E. N is number of electrons. E means charge of 1 electron. So, charge of 1 electron multiplied by number of electrons, so it gives in coulomb. So we have to compare both. So I into T is equal to NE. N into E is equal to I into T. And we have to derive number of electrons. Charge of 1 electron 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ in coulomb. Ampere I 1 time 60 seconds. Ampere into second means coulomb. So coulomb cut 60 upon 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹. 60 divided by 1.6 gives 37.5. −19 here will be plus. When we move one digit on left hand side, so rest will be increased. Number of electrons 3.75 × 10⁻²⁰. Now 2016 again. Zinc can be coated on iron to produce galvanized iron, but the reverse is not possible because of new properties. A, zinc is a lighter than iron. B, zinc has a lower melting point than iron. C, zinc has a lower negative electrode potential than iron, and D, zinc has a higher negative electrode potential than iron. First of all, question once again read. Zinc can be coated to iron. Iron upar zinc no coating thar, we are calling galvanized iron. So corrosion of iron will be stopped. If we are taking zinc and we are coating iron, fine, so it is not possible, iron will be corrosed. So we have to give proper reason for that term. So tell me proper reason for that term. Zinc having reduction potential minus 76 volt, where Fe having minus 0.44 volt. More negative value possesses zinc of the reduction potential. So oxidation potential will be plus 0.76, and here of iron will be plus. So losing nature of electron is highest of zinc, then Fe. So zinc will be coerced and iron will be protected. Here iron, when comes contact to the air, so it will be coerced. Zinc has higher negative electrode potential than iron. So answer is D. Now next question, very very most timely, last question of 2016. The pressure of hydrogen required to make the potential is also asked in 2016. The pressure of hydrogen required to make the potential of hydrogen electrode zero in pure water at 298 Kelvin is 10^-10 atmosphere, B 10^-4 atmosphere, 10^-14 atmosphere, and 10^-12 atmosphere. At which atmospheric pressure of hydrogen our potential of hydrogen electrode non-standard became zero? Yes sir. So 2H plus 2 electron gives H2 gas. Here suppose pressure is P, so reduction potential of hydrogen non-standard equal to standard 2H plus oblique H2 minus 0.059 upon 2 log. Here pressure of hydrogen is not unity, we have to define, so we have to take here. Now concentration of H plus and square of it, right? Here two more is taken. So If we are dividing by 2, then h plus. Here should be 1. So answer remains same. So here should be 1 half. It not convenient. But standard potential of hydrogen is 0. Now non-standard also became 0. At which pressure we have to define? In pure water, concentration of H plus we know 10 is to minus 7, so square of it 0.059 by 2 log pH2 upon 10 raised to minus 40. Yes, this one became 0. At that time pressure we have to, this one is already 0. And 0 thai, there pressure how much we have to derive. So 0.0296 log pH2 minus log 10 raised to minus 14. Yes. Division comes in minus 0 upon 0.296 0. So log pressure of H2 minus log minus 14. So this one comes here log 10 10 raised to minus 14. Log 10 pressure of hydrogen. We are applying both side anti log. Log log cut. So pressure of hydrogen is 10 raised to minus 14 atm. At this pressure, you can see here minus 14, 10 raised to minus 14, log 1, 0, this one became 0, which is also asked in 2016. Now, 2014, question asked in 2014. When 0.1 mole Mn of 2 minus is oxidized, the quantity of electricity required to completely oxidize the MnO4 minus 2 MnO4 minus manganate into permanganate is the A. 96500 coulomb, B 2 into 96500 coulomb, C 9650 coulomb, and D 96.50 coulomb. Yes. Actually, what happens here? MnO4, give me name. MnO4 minus 2 means manganate is converting into permanganate. Here oxidation number of manganese is plus 6. In MnO4, which is plus 7, all to the minus 8. Another side plus 8. 2 cut, so plus 6. Here all to the minus 8. Another side plus 8. 1 cut, then 7. So plus 6 into plus 7, increasing of 1. So it loses 1 electron. Yes. So when 1 mole MnO4 minus is converting into 1 mole MnO4 minus into MnO4 minus 2 into minus 1. So 1 mole electron, 1 farade, 96500 coulomb is required. But for getting, if 0.1 mole is converting, then how much? Simple, 96500 1.1 divided by 1. So 9650 coulomb is our answer. So answer is C. Yes, your answer is C. Now, question asked in 2013. A button cell used in watches, wristwatch, functions as following. Lead solid plus Ag2O solid plus H2O liquid gives 2Ag solid plus Zn2 plus aqua plus 2OH minus. If half cell potentials are Zn2 plus aqua plus 2 electron is gives Zn, so E degree means reduction potential minus 0.76 of the silver oxide plus H2O liquid gains 2 electron gives 2Ag solid plus 2OH minus, so will be plus 0.34 volt. The cell potential will be E, 0.84 volt, B, 1.34 volt, C, 1.10 volt, and D, 0.42 volt. So very simple, both electrodes are of reduction reactions having, so reduction potential is given. So which one is higher? Silver oxide. Yes, so E degree cell is equal to reduction potential of cathode minus reduction potential of anode. So here E degree cell Ag2O converting into Ag plus 1 into 0 minus E degree. Zn plus 2 converting into zinc. So plus 0.34 minus minus 0.76. volt is our answer. So C is our answer. Understood? Now more question of asked and another questions we will discuss in our next lecture. Till then, bye, take care, Jai Hind.